Hi everyone, welcome to How-FixIT. In this video guide, I'll show you how to disassemble an Apple Mac Mini, clean it from dust, and replace thermal paste. To disassemble the Mac Mini, you will need the following tools. Screwdriver set, tweezers, plastic opening tools, thermal grease, anti-static brush. I recommend using a magnetic mat during the repair process, which is especially useful in the case of this device. Throughout this disassembly, keep track of each screw so you can put them back in the right places. This will help successfully reassemble your device. And don't worry about losing any of the screws. All of them will definitely remain on the magnetic mat. In the description, I left links where to buy all the necessary tools. Turn over the Mac Mini and remove the bottom cover. Using a Torx T6 screwdriver with a hole inside, remove the screws on the metal panel. Lift up the metal panel, remove one more screw, and disconnect the Wi-Fi antenna. Lift up the fan and disconnect the cable from the Mac Mini motherboard. Let's move on to cleaning the fan from dust. Also, remove all dust from inside of the fan. Insert any handy tool into the hole on the Mac Mini motherboard and slide down. This helps remove the motherboard from the case. Disconnect the power cable from the motherboard. Use only an anti-static brush to clean the motherboard of dust. remove all screws on the heatsink. You can now remove the heatsink by lifting it up from the motherboard. Remove the old thermal paste from the CPU, as well as from the heatsink. If the thermal paste is very dry and difficult to remove, you can use isopropyl alcohol to wipe the paste. How to apply thermal grease. Apply a small amount of thermal paste to the CPU. Then, take a plastic tool and spread it evenly over the entire surface of the chip. If you still don't know which thermal paste to choose for your laptop, in the description, I left a link to a video where I test different thermal greases and choose the best one for the laptop. If your Mac Mini is overheating after dust cleaning and replacing thermal paste, probably the overheating issue could be due to a faulty heatsink. Watch my other video guide where I show you how to check the conduction of the heatsink. I left links in the description. Please note how I tighten the screws on the heatsink. It is necessary to tighten all the screws evenly on each side, with a few turns of each screw. Thank you. The repair is over. You are on How Fix It, and see you next time.